Assalamu alaikum. Good morning. Today I will show you the step-by-step procedure to deliver your lecture by using Blackboard account. So these are the following requirements. The first, internet connection, stable internet connection. The next one, laptop and the writing pad. If you have a Surface Pro, you need not to buy the writing pad. And then the third one, Microsoft OneNote. It should be installed in your laptop or Surface Pro, and obviously the Blackboard account using which we will deliver the class. So I will show you the step-by-step procedure. So I will open the OneNote here. This is a OneNote. This is my OneNote. So using which I am delivering the lecture. So first log in the Blackboard account. This is your login. Now I will create the section here. I will choose this section. So you can choose this section in which you want to create a section. So using under the tools, course tool, you will find the Blackboard Collaborates. So just click it here. Now there is no section is available here. If the section is available here, just you click on the section, it will be go directly to the join the section. But since the section is not created here, so I have to create the section first. So I will create section here, create section. You have to fill this section detail. I will write it the math 2 section. Suppose 5, and this is the event detail. You have to fill it here. So here the event detail is starting date and the ending date. So I will consider for 1 hour. If you want 2 hours, you can change it here by 2 hours timing. And the next one, and one more thing here, it is a repeat section. If the same classes has been repeat in each day of the week, you can write it as a repeat section. This we call it as a recurring meeting. Here it is weekly, monthly and daily basis. So I write it here weekly. Select the week as per your schedule. So I have a Sunday class, Monday class, and Tuesday I don't have a class. And then just click it, then Wednesday and Thursday. So these are the following things I have. Using my schedule, I will prepare this one. So this is the end after the occurrence. You have to fix the date here, exactly date. Since I will planning for the 8-week course program, so therefore it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here I will put it here. This is the date. After this date, the meeting will not be conducted. So here you can have option yearly entry. The participant, the student can entry before 15 minutes, 30 minutes, 45 minutes. You can choose as per your requirement. And the next one here, this is about the event detail. Now we are coming to the section detail. Here about the section, default attendees role. It is a participant, that is a student. And the next one, this is a very important thing, recording. If you put it this one, check this box, allow recording download. If you choose this option, the student can able to download the section, they can view offline. If you are not choosing this one, the student can view only on the online. Only the online is available, then only the student can view. Otherwise, the student not able to view your section. If you keep it this one, allow recording, the student can download the video and he can use in offline. And here, this is the participant share. It is share video, share audio, all the things. Here, if you have a large number of participants, 250 plus, you have to click this one. And I will put it safe. See here, this is the section. This is the session is created here. So if you want to click here, it will show the all the sections. So I will planning for 8 week details. So it shows all the section. See here, this is, I put it here, 6, 7, like this. Now I will put it the first section here, this. If you want to create, this is a recurring session. I will create one more. Since we are taking the Tuesday, is one. Okay. So this is a math one. So you can check the same thing. Yeah. Okay. Now this is section is already created, means it should be like this. So the status is in progress, means you can join the section by clicking double click. So you can join here, you can join section. So it depends upon your internet speed. So if you have a 4G with the stable internet connection, you can join immediately. It's depend on your internet connection. Once if you join the section, the first thing you have to do it here, share audio. Just click it here. If you want to share your video, you can share it. Your picture will be viewed by the student. Otherwise, you need not to do it this one. And this one we call it as open section menu, so through which we are getting. So I will put it here, start recording. Before this you have to start recording. I will take it start recording. Now the section has been recording. Now I have to choose, this is the this is open the collaborate panel. So this through which you can find it here, the number of attendees, how many students are there in your section. Here the list of student will be there. Here you can count the total attendees, total number of student. Here this is through which we can share content. So through which we can share our lecture. There are three primary content to share here. The first one, it is share blank whiteboard. If you press this one, you will find as a blackboard using Surface Pro or writing pad. You can write it here by clicking this pencil. So I write it here, math 2. But this is not recommended. So I can go through the share application. So it share application. See here, it is enter screen. So if you once if you share the enter screen, the student can view all your screen, what are the activities you are doing in your laptop or Surface Pro. The student can able to view that one. If you want to share only the window, the part of the window, you can click here. It is a application window. So here already I have opened the OneNote. So I press here OneNote. And then it is share. So the student can view only this part of the OneNote. He cannot view the entire screen. If you press, if you want to stop the section, stop sharing, you can stop here sharing, stop sharing. And if you want to do it the entire section, you can write it here the share application. This is the entire screen. Share. So the student can view all the activities what we have done. So if you enter the share enter screen, it will like this. It will show like this. Don't worry about this one. So I will open the OneNote. You can start giving your lecture using this one. So I write it here. This is math 2. Math 2. Find the inverse. Find the inverse of f of x is equal 3x plus 5. Now I write it the answer here. So given function y is equal 3x plus 5, and you have to change x and y. So this is x, this is y. Change x as y, y as x, and the remaining same, it is equal 3 plus 5. After this, solve for y. Here x minus 5 equal 3y, and then if you scroll it, it will come down. So now y is equal 1 over 3 x minus 5. So this is my f inverse. So if you want to write it the box, you can try with this. So this is your answer. So here, so you can give your lecture here by using OneNote. After the session is over, just you can do it here, stop sharing. If you stop sharing, the sharing will stop, the student cannot able to view after that. So I will put it here, sharing. You see here the entire screen will be gone out, so the sharing is finished. After doing this, completing the sharing, stopping sharing, now I can go with here, stop recording. Stop recording. The recording has been stopped and it is recorded. It will be saved in your Blackboard account. The student can view at any time. Once only if you choose the allow recording download, then only the student can able to download. Otherwise, he can only the view online. Now after that, I can go with here. This is leave section. That's it. Thank you for watching. Thank you.